Go on the job then.
Oh. No, I don't think so.
Oh.
Sooty. Good. Oh, and I see that you've put tape round the edge of the can. That's an excellent idea, because tin cans can be very, very sharp. Well, mine's already over here, and I've stuck pretty stickers over mine. What are we doing? Well, Sooty and I are just about to make a phone call. We haven't got a telephone. Ah, yes, we have, Sweep, here. What's funny? That's not a telephone. Well, what is it? It's an old baked tin. Well, yes, but it can work as a very simple telephone. Look, you take that can and go over there into another room, and I'll talk into my can. I'll prove that it works like a telephone. I'm kidding, I'm not. Yes, talk into a baked bean tin. Just try it, Sweet. Oh, I hope this all works, Sooty. I read about it in the encyclopedia, so it should. Ah, the string's gone tight. Now help me with the can, and let's take it to your bed. Come on. That's it. Can you hear me? Over. Hello, this is Sue calling. Can you hear me? Over. Oh, he can hear us, Sooty. You see, Sweep, I told you it would work. Am I coming over loud and clear? Over. He says it's unbelievable. He says it's better than an ordinary phone, Sooty. Oh, he says he sounds as if we're in the same room. He wants you to go and listen, Sooty. Go on then, just follow the string. Roger, Sweep. Sooty is on his way. Who's Roger? Oh, never mind, Sweet. Is Sooty there yet? All right, he's coming. Good. Sweet, just before you put Sooty on, just talk to me just to check that I'm receiving you properly. You know how quietly Sooty speaks. Sing something to me. Okay, of course we can, sausage brain. You're standing in the same room. Look, take your end somewhere else. Go on. Oh, that's typical of Sweep. Sooty, you make sure he doesn't come back. I'll watch this way and you watch that way. Sweep, Sweep, can you hear me, Sweep? Over. Oh, he can hear me, Sooty. You're a little bit fuzzy, Sweep. He says he hasn't brushed his hair yet. Hey, that's better. I can hear you fine now. Just keep singing something so I can tell when you're clearest. Oh, this is great. Come and have a listen, Sooty. Hang on. I can hear him just as well without the telephone. Sweep, you dozy dog. Look, it's no good if you're in the same room. Take your end somewhere else. Take it to Matthew's room.
Oh, hello. Wow. I've got something to show you. It's my latest toy. Well, actually, I haven't bought it. I've got it in 7 days free trial. It's fantastic. Do you know, Sweep? What are you doing with an old baked bean can? It isn't an old baked bean can. Well, it used to be. What is it now? It's a telephone. I remember. Baked bean can, piece of string, baked bean can on the other end. Who's on the other end? Sooty and Sue. Let's follow the string back. Let's pull the string up. Yes, sir, you're absolutely right. Have you had any success with your tin can phones, then?
Well, not really, Matthew. We're a bit disappointed, to be honest.
Are you? Well, I'll tell you what's probably wrong. You see, the string has got to remain very, very tight and very straight between the two cans. Now, I bet you were trying to make it go around corners, were you?
Yes, we were, yeah.
Yes, well, by trying to make it go around corners, you see, you stop the vibration travelling down the string.
What?
That's why it won't
you
work.
You mean we can't phone each other up if we're standing around a corner?
Well, not on one of these sort of phones, Sue, but I tell you what, you can with this.
Oh, what is it, Matthew?
That is a cellular telephone.
Ooh.
Yeah, a cellular telephone, that's right, sweet. It can't be a phone. Why not? Because they haven't got a wire. Sweet, it's a radio phone. It doesn't need a wire. Look at the little aerial on the top. Can we use it? Yeah, all right. Come on, look, there's one or two numbers here in the book. Try pressing this. Press power first. So if you get the power, that's it. And press 01246. Okay, go on. 8,000. Go on, 8,000. And press send. Okay, listen. Now listen.
Aquarius, don't let pressure from relatives worry you. Most of your family affairs will work out sooner or later.
The horoscope.
In the way you want them.
It is. It's today's horoscope.
We have plans to put money aside for
put
a rainy day.
Right, press end. Press end. That's good. Fantastic.
Oh, that is fantastic.
It's goodness.
Yes, can I have a go, Matthew?
You want to have a go? All right, then, Sue. Look, you press, hang on, press power for it. Press power again. That's it. And now you press 0483, Sue. 0483 04.
8071.
And press send. That's it. Now, I think you should like this. Listen to this. Listen to this one.
Place and chips.
Place and chips.
A recipe to delight the whole family.
Do you know what it is?
You will need 4
the recipe line.
4 large place fillets.
It's brilliant, isn't it? Turn it off, turn it off. That's it. You want to go, you want to go. All right. Tell you what, sweep. There we are. Press power first. And then press. Here's the next number. 0222. 0222. 8091. 8091. Okay. They're really good fun. Yes, they are good fun, aren't they, sweep? What have you just dialed? Well, when we press send, you'll find out what the weather's like in Glamorgan and Gwent, sweet. You don't want to know about that? Well, you would if you lived in Glamorgan or Gwent, wouldn't you?
Have you bought it?
Have I bought it? Well, no, I haven't actually, sir. I've got it on 7 days, free trial. But I must say, I am very impressed with them.
Yes, can we have another go on the phone?
No, it's not a toy. Now, come on, you three. Go and use the bathroom. Go on, all three of you. Use the bathroom. Go on, off you go. Now, I've got to be firm. Otherwise, I'd just sit here and use it all day. I think I'll just check what's on dialer disc. Well, that's an important phone call, isn't it? Dialer disc. Coming! Coming! Look after that for me, will you? I'm coming! Oh, thank you. Hey, look at this! Parcel! Yeah, I love parcels. Oh, there you are, you
three! Was it at the door, Matt?
It was at the door. Nobody. It was a parcel. Look, Sue. Can you help me to open it? Yes, go on, give me a hand. Come on, help me to open it. All right, they love parcels as well. Let's have a look and see what... Oh, look at that! It's a... It's another... Another radio phone. Look. Have I bought two? Well, I haven't bought one, actually, sweep. It's obviously a computer error. It means I can ring myself up. I cannot ring myself up because one of these two is going back this afternoon.
Oh, Matthew, before it goes back, can I just borrow it so I can ring a couple of friends? Just so I can say I've used one.
Well, all right then, Sue, but listen, you must make sure they're local calls, all right? And only
oh,
a couple,
thank you,
okay?
Matthew. Now, what's the code for China?
You mean China? What? What?
Kidding.
You're going to play in the garden. Hang on, sweet, come back. Listen, I want you to pop down to the local shop for me and get a tin of spaghetti. I just fancy some spaghetti for my lunch. Would you do that? You find the money on the lounge table. Okay, then, sweet. Off you go. You're going to go and use the bathroom. All right, go and use the bathroom. Go on. You know, the temptation with these things is to just make telephone calls just for the sake of doing it. You've got to be very strong-willed. I wonder what the weather's like in Invercockaleeky, isn't it?
You know, these things knock spots off the old baked bean tins. Oh, I wish someone would ring me up. Oh dear, what have I done? Is that really the phone ringing? How do we answer it? Oh, hang on. Hello? Hello? Who is it? It's you? Who's you? Sweep? You're kidding! Where are you, Sweep? He's in a telephone box, Sooty. Down in the village? What are you doing down there? Buying spaghetti? Well, what are you on the phone for? Was it a large can or a small can. I don't know, Sweep. Why didn't you ring Matthew? His number's engaged. Well, put your phone down and try him in a few minutes. I wonder who Matthew is ringing.
Oh, hi. I'm trying to get Sue on her radio phone. She's been engaged for absolutely ages. Oh, just a minute. It's ringing. It's ringing now. Yeah.
Hello? Is that you again, Sweep?
No, it's not Sweep. It's Matthew.
Oh, hello, Matthew.
Hi, Sue. Whereabouts are you? Where are you?
I'm still in the bathroom.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Is Sooty up there with you?
No, he went downstairs. Someone was knocking at the back door.
Really? Oh, he's here now. He's got a parcel with him. What were you talking to Sweep about for all that time, Sue?
Oh, he rang from a phone box. Something about a tin of spaghetti. I told him to ring you in a moment or so, but he said your phone was engaged.
Yes.
Well, it's typical of Sweep not to listen to you about whether the tin was to be large or small, or perhaps you didn't say either way. But the problem is, he's got so little common sense. I'm surprised you sent him in the first place.
Whoa. Sue, are you talking to me on the radio phone?
Of course I am. Are you?
Well, yes, I am, but if I'm talking to you on one, and you're talking to me on the other, then what on earth is this one? What? It's outside the back door. Oh, no, they've sent another one. Oh, it's ringing. Hello?
Hello?
Just a minute. No, I'm not talking to you. I'm talking to the new phone. Hello? Hello?
Transfer charge call from a Teddington call box. Will you accept the charge?
You're kidding.
I'm not in the habit of playing games.
All right, I'm sorry.
Will you accept the charge or not?
Yes. Very touchy. Yes. Hello? Oh, Sweep! Sweep! How did you know this number? Shot in the dark?
Hello? Hello?
Just a minute, hang on. Hello, Sue?
Is that Sweep ringing?
Yes, it is. Why?
Is he still in the village?
I think he is, yes. Why?
Ask him if he's going anywhere near the dry cleaners.
I'll ask him, just a minute. Sweep, we've got Sue on the other phone. She wants to know, are you going anywhere near the dry cleaners? You can if she wants. Okay, I'll tell her. Just a minute, hang on. Sue, he says he can if you want.
Ooh,
why?
I wonder if he could pick up my dress.
I'll ask him. Hang on a minute. Can you pick up Sue's dress? I'll ask her. He says, how will he know which one it is?
It's dark blue with pale blue polka dots.
Yeah, okay, I'll tell him. It's dark blue. Just a minute. This is ridiculous. I'm not having this. Look, Sweet, would you come back home immediately? Sue, will you come down from the bathroom? Put the phone down. Come down from the bathroom. Thank you. This is ridiculous. Three radio phones. I mean, I'm very impressed with them, but one would be quite sufficient. They're going back. Let's find out where they came from. Here's a delivery note. Let's find out the company name. Here's our address. Look, Sutteries, Teddington, Middlesex. Deliver one dozen radio phones. One dozen radio... Sutty, were there any more parcels like this outside the door? How many? Another nine just like it. Nine? 10? 11? And Sue's got one. That's 12 phones. It's time for action. You and I are going to take all these phones back to the company that they belong to.
Oh, right? Matthew, we heard what you were saying. Can't Sweep and I come?
No, you can't, Sue. You've got to stay here.
Why?
Well, in case the phone rings.
Ooh.
In case the phone rings. We've got a dozen phones. Yes. Come on, Sue. Come on, keep up. It's down here. Hang on. Whoa. Is it down there? Or is it up there? But look, come over here. Come over here. What have I done with that address? Oh, there you are. Sooty, look, the address. The address where we're going to take the telephones to. The radio phones. You haven't got it. But you picked it up in the house. You thought I'd got it. Well, I haven't got it. And if you haven't got it, where are we going to take the phones to? Hmm? What are we going to do? Ring Sue? That's a very good idea. Where am I going to find a phone? Where am I going to find a... There's a dozen in the basket. Oh, that's it! Of course, silly me. There's radio phones in the basket. Ring Sue on one of these. Can you enter the number in, Sooty? Hang on a minute. They're a really good idea, aren't they? It's a shame we're going to... Oh, hang on. Hello, Sue? Yes. Yes, we're going to have the address where we're going to take the radio phones back to. Yeah, the factory, yes. 23 High Street. Yeah, okay. Thank you. Right, press end. Look at all those boys and girls. Hi, kids.
Hi.
Actually, I've got an idea. We could use the radio phone and have some fun with the children. Shall we do that? Come over here, kids. Come on. Hi there. Hey, who knows who this is?
Sue.
And who knows what this is? What is this?
A telephone.
What sort of a telephone?
Walkie
special.
Walkie-talkie.
A walkie-talkie radio phone? Yes, they were right. Those ones said radio phone. Who wants to have a go with it? Who likes to have a go? You'd all like to have a go. Well, look, tell you what, we'll press power here. What's your name?
Tony.
Tony, okay, hang on a minute, Tony. Why don't you give your house a ring and see if there's anybody in? You dial your number.
Hello? Who's that?
Tony.
Hello, where are you phoning from?
Down by the precinct, down by the newsagents.
What, from a phone box?
No, I'm on a radio phone.
Are you? Whose phone is that?
Well, Matthew bought it.
Matthew who?
The Sooty Show, of the Sooty Show.
What, Sooty? The real Sooty?
Yeah.
Tell me about him. Are you sure it's Sooty?
Yeah, he's yellow, black ears, and Matthew's got a ginger beard.
Ginger beard? That's a drink, isn't it? Yeah. Oh, ginger beard.
4779.
Hello, Mum. Mrs. Gregory here.
Hello. Where are you?
At the moment, I am in front of a trolley.
Where are you ringing from? Are you in a phone box?
Yeah, by the precinct.
Whose telephone is it?
Matthew Corbett.
Who's there with you?
Sooty.
Is it the real Sooty?
The real Sooty.
The real Sooty? Oh, look, he's taking a bow.
Yes, I'm sure.
Well, will you give Sooty a big kiss from me? Yes, give Matthew a kiss too.
What? What did she ask?
Could I give Matthew and Sooty a big kiss?
Well, give Sooty a big kiss. Give Sooty a big kiss.
Give Sooty.
Go on, lean forward.
No, I'll hold his paws.
Kiss.
Oh,
give
no.
It. Oh, now what does she want to know? What does she want to know?
Has he got his water pistol?
He hasn't got his water pistol.
No, he hasn't got his water pistol. Oh, he has got... No!
Yes, he has.
No, 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 you've got
it.
That's very naughty. Gregory, you're covered in water.
Has he got his water pistol?
No, but I have.
What did she say?
She said, has he got his water pistol?
Where is your water pistol? We haven't got... You've got his water pistol! No, 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 don't squirt him! Oh, please! No, no, you're not supposed to be... No, 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 please don't do
that.
No, you mustn't do... No, don't do that. Hello, Mum. We're going to go now because we're going to take all these radio phones back to the place where we got them. So, bye-bye. Bye-bye. Come on, kids, you can give me a hand. Come on, we're going to take this back. Come on, back to the factory. You know where it is. Down the high street. Down here. Careful. Over this way. That's it. Down this way. That's it. On this way. Wagons roll!
So how long did you spend talking to the children and their mummies, Matthew?
Oh, it was a good hour, you know,
oh,
Sue.
Really?
And then we took all the radio phones back to the factory, to the manager.
Uh-huh.
Mr. Woodward, I think his name was. Nice man. What did he say? Well, he said that, as we thought, sweet, there'd been a major computer breakdown and we weren't meant to get any of those radio phones at all. So he took them all back.
All of them?
Yeah, I'm afraid
dear.
So. It's a shame, really, because I thought they were fantastic things. Still, that's that. Oh, he did send a little something round by way of apology.
Oh, it's probably a box of chocolates. Can we open them? Mm. Oh, you hope it's a box of bones, sweet. Yes.
What do you think it might be, Sooty? You think it might be a box full of honey? Well, yes, you would think that, wouldn't you? Listen, I think I know what it is. Listen to that. Let's get it open. I think that it might... It is! Look! It's a radio phone!
Hey!
Hey, let's pull the aerial up, Sooty. Pull the aerial up. And let's see who's ringing us up, shall we? Let's see who it is. Yeah. Hello? Mr. Woodward? It's Mr. Woodward. Yeah? You're kidding, really? For us? Oh, that's fantastic. But bye, and thank you. Look at this. This is with the compliments of the company. It's ours!
Oh, are you happy now, Matthew?
Yes, of course I'm happy, Sue. Tell you what would make me even happier, if you lot could join us again soon. All right? See you then. Bye-bye,
bye-bye.
Everybody.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye
now.
What about tea?
We'll be phoning Sooty up again same time next week. Still to come today, Victoria Wood presents The Book Tower, all about dreams. But next, Dennis, who becomes a cowboy.